I hope this message finds you safe, healthy, and in a reasonably good place. Duke University has been surveying CFOs every quarter for nearly 25 years. This past quarter, we just completed the most remarkable survey we've ever done. The survey opened on March 3rd and closed on April 3rd. So over this 5-week period, we were able to watch business plans by US CFOs come completely unraveled. In fact, there was an inflection point about March 15th. So if you look before March 15th at the CFO Optimism Index, optimism was a little bit below the long run average. If you look after March 15th, CFO optimism has fallen to an all-time low. CFOs are as pessimistic right now as they've been at any time in the history of our survey, including at the depths of the Great Recession. If you look before March 15th, sales revenue was expected to grow by about 4% over the next 12 months. That's kind of weak, but still positive. If you look after March 15th, sales revenue is now expected to fall by 1 or 2% over that 12-month period. Now keep in mind, that includes any kind of rebound that we have in this summer and into the fall. Over the 12-month period, we'll recover, but not enough to get our heads back above water over the 12-month period. If you look before March 15th, business spending, hiring, and wages were all expected to grow at about 4%. You look after March 15th, spending and employment are now expected to fall over the 12-month period, even after we have a rebound in the summer and fall, and wages over 12-month period will only grow by about 1%. So overall, things are looking pretty bleak from this forecast. Now, these numbers I've been quoting are just for the United States. If you go to cfosurvey.org, you can see numbers around the world, and this same pattern holds everywhere. Starting in the second half of March, CFOs around the world are predicting some of the worst numbers we've ever heard out of the survey, and they're more pessimistic than they've ever been. Now, to be clear, we don't expect economic activity to stay at this low level where we are here in the middle of April. We do expect a rebound, but even with that rebound, we won't get ourselves completely back above water over the 12-month period. I'll talk to you again in June and give you an update on where things stand.